When do you say a city is beautiful? When it has good landscape, beautiful buildings and gardens, lovely lanes and streets? Well, then you're wrong. A city becomes beautiful when it is clean. Without cleanliness, all your landscape, buildings, lanes and gardens won't help in making the city beautiful. How a city is made clean? When people living in the city invest in efficient waste management system. City becomes beautiful when it's clean. Similarly, your body becomes healthy when it's clean. In Sanskrit, body is called sharira, or that eliminates waste and toxins every moment through urine, stool and sweat. And if this process is not happening properly, it becomes the main cause for all diseases and ailments. Now, why the waste disposal system fails? It is because of sedimentation of excess sugar in the body. In 10,000 BC, the average sugar consumption of a human was just 20 tablespoons a year. But today, an average human consumes 22 tablespoons of sugar on one single day. Reasons for this? The change in lifestyle, irregular food habits and consumption of junk food, and lack of exercise compared to bygone era. In Ayurveda, the diseases are divided into two: diseases due to overnutrition and diseases due to undernutrition. And treating diseases due to overnutrition, where sugar sedimentation is a prime feature, is very difficult. Today, in developed and developing countries, major diseases are due to overnutrition. Sugar is actually glue. The undigested sugar becomes sticky in nature and sticks to small intestine like glue, which in Ayurveda is called Aaama. This glue prevents absorption of nutrients and body does everything to remove it. Like you clean a dirty plate using an acidic dishwash liquid, body produces acid to clean up this glue. What will the acid do after cleaning this glue? Simple, it enters the bloodstream and takes the sticky material along with it. Body is forced to generate unwanted fat and also releases calcium absorbed from the bones to neutralize this acid. The sticky materials and acids make your blood impure and lead to inflammation. In Ayurveda, it is called shobhanam. The impure blood which flows all over your body becomes the root cause of a number of diseases like arthritis, acne and dark circle, acidity, low immunity, hypertension, stress, less sleep, depression, constipation, weight gain, low sex drive, etc. Setting right the waste disposal mechanism in your body is the best cure for these diseases. The Panchakarma treatment in Ayurveda is the most effective way to clean the toxins and to restore the waste disposal mechanism of your body. With proper waste disposal system in place, your body becomes clean, energetic and healthy. When it comes to authentic Ayurvedic treatment, Sitaram Ayurveda has a long-lasting legacy of authentic Ayurveda and stands head and shoulders above the others. This noble venture, under the leadership of Sri Parameshwar Iyer, Sri Balaram Iyer and Sri Gopalakrishna Iyer, was initiated by the then Maharaja of Cochin, His Highness Sri Ramavarma XV, in 1921. In 1950s, Sri Devaraja Iyer, son of Sri Parameshwar Iyer, took over the reign of the company. His son, Dr. D. Ramanathan, who is a graduate in Ayurveda and a guru by the Rashtriya Ayurveda Vidyapeeth, succeeded him and further contributed to the growth of the company. His clear vision and hard work not only earned him the Best Doctor Vakbada Award of Kerala State Government, but also made Sitaram one of the top Ayurvedic companies in India.
ക്ലൈമറ്റിൽ ഉണ്ടാകുന്ന വ്യാധിയനം കൊണ്ടും മനുഷ്യൻ്റെ പ്രതിരോധ ശക്തി കുറഞ്ഞു 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 വരികയാണ്. അപ്പോൾ അതിന് ആ പ്രതിരോധ ശക്തി കുറയുമ്പോൾ ആ പ്രതിരോധ ശക്തി കൂട്ടുക എന്നുള്ളതാണ് ഒരു ചികിത്സയിൽ ഏറ്റവും പ്രധാനമായിട്ടുള്ളത്. അതിൽ ഏറ്റവും നല്ല ചികിത്സാ രീതി പറയുന്നത് ആയുർവേദത്തിൻ്റെ പഞ്ചകർമ്മ ചികിത്സയാണ്. അപ്പോൾ പഞ്ചകർമ്മ ചികിത്സ എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ ഇയാളുടെ ഇമ്മ്യൂൺ കപ്പാസിറ്റി കുറയാനുള്ള കാരണങ്ങൾ എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ അയാളുടെ ഭക്ഷണ രീതിയും കാലാവസ്ഥയിലുണ്ടാകുന്ന പ്രശ്നങ്ങളും മാനസികമായിട്ട് എല്ലാ പ്രശ്നവും കൂടി ഉണ്ടാകുന്ന ഒരു ഓളിസ്റ്റിക്കായിട്ടുണ്ടാകുന്ന പ്രശ്നം കൊണ്ടുകൊണ്ടാണ് അയാളുടെ ഇമ്മ്യൂൺ കപ്പാസിറ്റി കുറഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്നത്. അപ്പോൾ നമ്മളവിടെ വരുന്ന ഒരു രോഗി വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ അയാളുടെ നാഡിയും അയാളുടെ കോശവും ശരീരപ്രകൃതിയും വാദപിത്ത കവങ്ങളെല്ലാം അനലൈസ് ചെയ്ത് മോഡേൺ പാരാമീറ്റേഴ്സിൻ്റെ ടൂൾസുകൾ, ഡയഗ്നോസിസ് സിസ്റ്റങ്ങൾ, ബ്ലഡ് പിക്ചർ, എക്സ്റേ, MRI ആവശ്യമുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ അതെല്ലാം നോക്കിയതിന് ശേഷം കൃത്യമായി ഒരു ആയുർവേദത്തിൻ്റെ ഡയഗ്നോസിസ് കൂടി പ്രകൃതി മനസ്സിലാക്കിയതിന് ശേഷം അയാൾക്ക് പൂർവ്വകർമ്മങ്ങൾ ചെയ്യുന്നു. പൂർവ്വകർമ്മങ്ങൾ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് അയാളുടെ അഗ്നി ശുദ്ധീകരിക്കുക, അഗ്നി വളരെ ഡൈജസ്റ്റീവ് സിസ്റ്റം കൃത്യമായി കൊണ്ടുവരിക എന്നുള്ളതാണ് പൂർവ്വകർമ്മങ്ങൾ. അത് ഉദ്വർത്തനം, അതുപോലെ തന്നെ കഞ്ഞികൾ, പേയ, അങ്ങനെയുള്ള ചില പ്രത്യേകതകൾ ചെയ്തതിന് ശേഷം 3 ദിവസമോ 7 ദിവസമോ അയാൾക്ക് സ്നേഹപാനം മാത്രം നൽകുന്നു. ആ സ്നേഹപാനം നൽകുന്ന ദിവസം അയാൾക്ക് കഞ്ഞി മാത്രമാണ് കൊടുക്കുന്നത്, വേറെ ഒരു ഫുഡും അയാൾക്ക് കൊടുക്കുന്നില്ല. അതിനുശേഷം 3 ദിവസത്തിന് ശേഷം നസ്യവും വമനവും വിരേചനവും കഷായവസ്ഥയും സ്നേഹവസ്ഥയും എല്ലാം കഴിഞ്ഞതിന് ശേഷം അയാൾക്ക് രസായന ചികിത്സ ചെയ്തു കൊടുത്താൽ അയാളുടെ ഇമ്മ്യൂൺ കപ്പാസിറ്റി വർദ്ധിച്ചിരിക്കും എന്നുള്ള യാതൊരു സംശയവുമില്ല.
All the medicines used are manufactured in the company's own factory, which is GMP certified, having latest quality checking parameters, and the products are best in quality. Here, modern machines are used without diluting the traditional methods of preparation. There is a modernized lab to test and ensure the quality of the medicines. These are some of the stringent methods followed by Sitaram Ayurveda and Sitaram Beach Retreat to ensure quality. Today, the full-fledged manufacturing unit spans across 100,000 square feet and produces 500 authentic Ayurvedic formulations to ensure the genuinity of Ayurvedic treatment. And the name Sitaram has become a significant one in the Ayurvedic world. Sitaram Beach Retreat is a brainchild of a young visionary, Dr. Vignesh Devraj, who is Dr. Ramanathan's son and an MD in Ayurvedic medicine. Sitaram Beach Retreat is an authentic Ayurvedic clinic where treatment is done in a serene and refreshing atmosphere. Thorough and intense treatment like Panchakarma becomes a tedious exercise when done in the four walls of a room. This is where Sitaram Beach Retreat makes the difference. The beautiful ambience of Natika Beach, the refreshing sea breeze and tranquil atmosphere makes this intense treatment into an exciting experience.
Here, with Ayurveda, we mainly try to focus on three aspects that cause disease. The first is called Aaama, which is the undigested food particles when there is too much of food intake. It has to enter the bloodstream and makes the blood impure and thick, which is called as Kletha in Ayurveda. This Kletha in the blood, it circulates all around the body and it can lead to inflammation, which is called as shobham. So these are the three aspects. When you focus and reduce these three, the body has to get back to its natural health. So we try to give herbs and herbal combinations to remove the undigested food particles completely. Thereby your digestive tract is completely cleansed. And this makes good production of pure blood, and thereby the possibilities of inflammation is completely reduced. Here, we don't have any ready-made packages. All the treatments will be customized after observing your clinical condition when you are here.
In Sitaram, you can find a rare blend of authentic Ayurveda and modern concepts of medicine. The physician will start the process by asking certain questions about the digestion, heaviness after having food, motion, and the nature of its formation. By examining the patient's tongue, eyes, nails, and pulse, the nature of metabolism and the status of energy in the body can be understood. Blood, urine, feces, and phlegm are thoroughly tested, and these test results give a clearer picture on the patient's health condition And on the basis of this, the nature of treatment is decided. The medicines given during the preparatory treatments are Deepana and Pajana. Deepana means that burns or digests, and Pajana means that cleanses. Use of these herbs cleans your digestive system and your appetite shoots up and you feel the real hunger. Generally, on the first day, Ruchakriya or Kiri is given to the patient. Kiri involves an Ayurvedic massage with a mildly heated pouch of various herbal combinations. The nature of Kiri differs from patient to patient depending on the level of inflammation in the body. This treatment is recommended for those with high blood pressure and cholesterol levels. It makes the body more flexible and removes stiffness, promotes sound sleep, and makes the entire body strong and sturdy. This helps to absorb all the inflammation in the body and even in the extremities when there is shobham. Depending upon the inflammation or swelling, a treatment called nasyam is administered to the patient to remove unwanted phlegm and toxins from the body. Nasyakarma is the procedure of administering medicine through the nose. The medicine administered through the nostrils easily spreads all over the head. The nostrils are believed to be the entrance of the head. The medicine used will be a combination of herbs and oils, which will differ from patient to patient. Dhupanam, a procedure of inhaling medicated smoke through the nose and exhaling it through the mouth, is also done along with nasya. Nasyakarma cleanses accumulated phlegm and toxins from the head and neck region.
My name is Uli Hermann. I'm coming from Germany. I'm the third time in Kerala, always for Ayurvedic treatment, but particular in this Ayurvedic hospital, I'm more than satisfied due to, let's say, two main reasons. The first one is I got nasya treatments, and within the first day, a lot of wax came out of my nose, which was definitely like a parasite disturbing my health. And the other treatment was the shirodhara, particularly to be used for lowering my blood pressure, with tremendous results. It's unbelievable what these guys are doing with us.
In Ayurvedic textbooks, there is a Sanskrit sutra which says sneha saroyam hi purushaha, which means the major essence of a healthy body is fat. The fat means the good fat we need. And in Sanskrit, the word for that is sneham. The root meaning of that is that which keeps things together. So in a healthy body, the fat level or the good fat level is very high. At the same time, the more dry it is, the more possibility of ill health, low energy and more diseases. So we always try to optimize the level of good fat in the body, which is sneham. So there are two words that we always focus, which is sneham, which means good fat, and ruksha, which means dryness. The more the dryness, more ill health. The more good fat, the better the efficiency of the body and more energy and good health. So before we start the purificatory Panchakarma process, usually on the fourth or sixth day, there is a procedure that we start called Snehapanam, which means progressive ghee therapy. And why we select ghee? Ghee is taken from the cow's milk that is made into a butter, and this butter is clarified as ghee. And the chemistry of ghee is closest to the good fat our body needs. And that's why we use ghee as a preparatory procedure before we start the purification of Panchakarma. The ghee that is given to the patient according to the condition, the ghee is processed with various herbs. When there are particular herbs, if the condition of the patient is with stress levels, if the issue is with fertility, another kind of herbs are used. These herbs, its fat-soluble extracts are blended with this ghee, and when this ghee is given, these extracts are blended with the body. So usually this ghee therapy, it varies from 3 days to 7 days depending on the dryness of the body. And it is always given at the time of sunrise. Why we give at sunrise? Sunrise is the meeting point between the moon time and sun time, which is also the kapha time. And there is a particular digestive power at this point of time in the human body that helps in the absorption of this ghee. So on the first day, the ghee will be absorbed like a blotting paper which absorbs the ink. And second day, when the dosage is increased, a time will come when it reaches a saturation level, when the ghee can never be absorbed anymore. And the ghee will be rejected outright by the digestive tract. And we assess this by the body's way of reaction. The person will say that he has an aversion to this ghee, and when the ghee is given, sometimes he passes out as it is, or he has a nauseating feeling. And the skin will be like he applied oil, or it will be like he just applied some moisturizer. And that's the time when we understand the digestive tract has reached the saturation point of this ghee intake. Intense purification process by Panchakarma is going on. It's very important for the body to focus most of its energy in the cleansing process. Only then it will be able to let the toxins out of the system. So it's very important, heavy food that takes a lot of energy to digest should not be given. So Ayurveda prescribes a very easy to digest food which is called as kanji. Kanji is the rice gruel, which is the easiest, one of the easiest form of carbohydrate that can be easily digested and which does not ferment. So usually at the time of intense cleansing, kanji is what is prescribed. Once the saturation point of the ghee therapy is achieved, there is a particular food that is given prior to the vomiting process. So this is given on the day after the saturation point is achieved and the day before the vomiting process is done. This special food is rich with natural sugar. The reason is, the sugar being sticky in nature, it goes and blends with the ghee that is suspended in the digestive tract. So it acts as an anchor that helps to take out all the toxins, especially in the upper part of the body. 70 to 80% of our body is made up of water element. And this water element in Ayurveda is represented as kapha. And this unwanted kapha can lead to a lot of disorders in the body, especially in the upper part. And one of the purificatory process in Panchakarma to eliminate this unwanted water element is called as vamanam. Vamanam means therapeutic vomiting. In fact, the word vomit has its root in the Sanskrit word called vaman, which means to throw it out. So after a massage is done and a steaming is done, the patient is made to sit and a minimum of 3 to 4 glasses of milk is given, followed with some herbs that induces the vomiting. And it is followed with some liquids according to the condition and the way his bouts are coming. And after a little bit of stress and vomiting, the patient feels completely relaxed, refreshed. It's like a huge block of energy is completely let out. And this is especially good when you have too much of inflammation, mucus, and even we notice that patients who are having snoring issues due to nasal blockage or inflammation there, this is known to completely subsidize that. And this is one of the best problems that we see that can be solved with vamanam.
Ich bin Anne und ich bin aus Deutschland. Ich bin vor 12 Tagen da angekommen in einem sehr, sehr schlechten körperlichen Zustand. Durch Sabine bin ich dann auf die Panchakarma-Kur gekommen und habe eigentlich sofort gewusst, dass das was war, was mir helfen kann. Aber die großen Bedenken habe ich gehabt, wie ich gehört habe, dass man da erbrechen muss. Nach den Tagen der Vorbereitung und den Gietagen ist dann der Tag gekommen, wo dieses Erbrechen angesetzt war. Und ich habe die Nacht vorher auch nicht geschlafen. Um 5:30 in der Früh war dann der Termin. Und voller Sorge bin ich da hingegangen und habe mir dann gedacht, jetzt kann ich nicht mehr aus. Jetzt mache ich einfach, was die mir sagen. Wie die Prozedur mal begonnen hat, dann ist das, ich bin das einfach nur durchgegangen, wie das mir gesagt worden ist, und es hat wunderbar funktioniert. Es war auch nicht peinlich, wie ich mir das vorher gedacht habe, wenn man vor 3 Menschen da erbrechen muss. Wie die Prozedur vorbei war, habe ich mich sehr, sehr erleichtert gefühlt. Ich war völlig frisch, ich bin rausgegangen und ich war völlig erleichtert, als hätte ich 50 Kilo verloren. Und dann war ab dem Zeitpunkt war eigentlich bei mir vieles gut. Mit diesem Erbrechen ist alles, was in den letzten 14 Jahren, was sie bei mir angesammelt hat und was ich irgendwo nicht ausleben konnte oder ist von mir gefallen. Ich habe das jetzt alles los. Und ich habe eine Lebensfreude und eine Energie seitdem, ist unbeschreiblich.
The next day is reserved for rest and the patient is allowed to recoup. A treatment which combines oil massage and heat treatment is given to the patient. This is followed by Shirodhara, which involves gentle pouring of liquids over the forehead. These liquids can include oil, buttermilk, milk, coconut water, or even plain water. Shirodhara has been used to treat a variety of conditions, including eye diseases, sinusitis, allergic rhinitis, graying of hair, neurological disorders, memory loss, etc.
This is a procedure called steaming. In Ayurveda, it's called as svedana. The concept of this treatment is, it helps to remove the inflammation if there is any in the lymphatic system or in the extremities. By doing that, it helps to cleanse the toxins in the peripheries before we get into the real cleansing of inside. And this is usually done before we do one of the main treatments in Panchakarma called as virechana, which is therapeutic purgation. Where we give a medicine in the morning, which is the time of pitta, where this medicine goes inside and it cleanses the whole of small intestine, where the patient has to go at least 5 to 6 times depending on the dosage of the medicine we give. And this also, apart from cleaning the small intestine, it helps to clean the liver and also to gallbladder, because these two organs are closely related with the metabolism that is happening in the small intestine. So when the liver is less burdened, the elimination of toxins is much easier.
The patient is asked to take rest the following day. Thara is an Ayurvedic treatment which includes the application of a continuous stream of medicated liquids. Thara relaxes the body and improves the blood flow. It helps in relieving stress and fatigue, improves sensory function, and it is also very effective for insomnia, depression and headache. For the next few days, the patient undergoes various varieties of Thara during the daytime.
While the whole of digestive tract is being purified,
The most important part and the difficult part that can be purified is the large intestine. Why? Because large intestine is the junkyard of the whole digestive tract. It is storing all the toxins, the waste materials, the fermented materials, and also the bad microbes or bacteria. So cleaning that is one of the most profound aspects of Panchakarma. And the process that is used is called as vasti or therapeutic enema. You know, it is very difficult to clean orally the large intestine, because whatever is consumed orally, by the time it is reaching the small intestine, it will be absorbed or the liver will interfere with its process. So the only way is to go the other way around, which is the enema process. This vasti, it can be from 3 days to 9 days, depending on the severity of the condition. And once this large intestine is cleansed, the energy levels of the body instantly goes up. It's like formatting a computer which is full of virus or bugs. And instantly, the computer is so easy to use. Same way, the body's energy levels really goes up. And also, it is one of the best treatments for allergies, for sexual disorders, for constipation, back pain, and whatever is related with large intestine, because large intestine is considered as the seat of Vata dosha.
Ich bin Karin und komme aus Deutschland. Ich mache hier eine Panchakarma Kur, die ich voriges Jahr im Oktober schon einmal gemacht habe. Ich war sehr stark stoffwechselkrank. Das hat sich geäußert in Ausschlag im Gesicht, Pickel, Rötungen, Gewicht war sehr stark, also ich war viel stärker als wie jetzt. Und während dieser Kur ist mir klar geworden, dass es ein ganz wichtiger Teil dieser Panchakarma-Kur die Einläufe sind. Diese Einläufe, ich hatte vorher furchtbar Angst, einen Einlauf zu bekommen. Das hat sich aber alles, diese Einläufe werden so professionell gemacht, dass man da überhaupt ganz relaxed hingehen kann. Was mir dann noch aufgefallen ist, ist, dass man sehr viel loslässt von einem. Die Ängste werden einem klar und so viele Dinge, was im Leben nicht passen, werden einem klar und werden dadurch auch erledigt. Das ist zwar ein Prozess, der nicht gleich, beendet ist mit der Panchakarma-Kur, aber ich habe die Chance bekommen, das alles in die Reihe zu bekommen. Am Schluss, letztendlich kann ich sagen, ich habe 15 Jahre jünger ausgesehen, habe mich 20 Jahre besser, also jünger gefühlt. Es war einfach rundum gut. Ich kann es jedem nur empfehlen und ich bin das beste Beispiel. Ich bin wieder hier und mache das Gleiche noch einmal.
After Vasti, it ensures that good blood is generated inside the body. And it is followed by a procedure called rectamosha, which makes this pure blood to circulate all over the body in a good and fine way. It removes the toxins, it removes the complications in the circulations and makes the body detox, as well as it improves the immunity and also the complexion of your body. This is done by taking small quantity of blood from your body so that new blood is generated inside your body. Rectamoksham is not done on elderly people, those who are anemic, pregnant women, and on ladies, those who are on menstruating days. With Rectamoksha, the whole Panchakarma procedure comes to an end. And this makes sure that your complete body from mouth to rectum is cleansed.
What do you gain after the Panchakarma treatment? The quality of your digestion and metabolism increases. You will start getting a sound sleep. Your mind becomes relaxed and de-stressed. You will find yourself more flexible, cheerful, energetic, creative and focused.
Hope you enjoyed your stay here. You know, when you clean your car or service your car, you don't want to drive it on a muddy road. Same way, your body is quite clean. So you can sustain this good energy by following good habits. This good energy can last up to 10 months or even 1 year, depending on how you follow. so that your health can be sustained long. So we wish you a very healthy, happy, long, productive life. Just come back again. It's good to do it once a year.
To help humanity achieve sustained optimum health. This is the concept Sitaram upholds. So, all you have to do is decide to come here, and the hardest part is over.